Hey,
Well, hi, Miguel. Nice to meet you. How are you doing?
I'm good. I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing good. I watched Blue Miracle earlier this week. I thought it was fantastic. Such a genuine and like authentic message.
I'm Omar, but boys call me Papa Omar.
You could join us.
Join you?
Yeah, a casa hogar.
Yes, totally.
It was good. So premiere date is tomorrow. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling good. I am really excited for my friends and family and the world to watch. Yeah, I'm feeling good. I'm feeling really excited about it. It feels kind of crazy that it's tomorrow. Feels like such a long time, but it's tomorrow.
When did you film the movie?
I think we started in October or November of 2019.
Wow. So yeah, a long time coming.
Yeah, long time coming.
And this is your Netflix debut, right?
This is my Netflix debut.
Yeah. Are you a fan of the streaming platform? Are you like binge watching anything right now?
Oh, yeah. I love so much on Netflix. I love Chef's Table. It's like what I watch. I think I've seen every episode like 3 or 4 times. And oh my God. So many other shows, but Chef's Table is definitely my favorite. Great British Baking Show that's on there now.
Yes, everyone watches that. We love it.
We love it. I'm a huge movie buff and TV buff too, so I've been watching a bunch of the new shows that have been coming out. I love The Queen's Gambit, and so many others. I mean, there's so many.
Yeah, no, it's definitely, it's hard to pinpoint. My favorite question to kind of warm up for the interviews to ask people is I'm always like, during the pandemic, you know, what interest or hobbies did you pick up? And then also, what are you currently binge watching? So okay. I don't know if you already mentioned that right now, but if you wanted to give us a little inside look into what you've been up to.
Yeah, so during the quarantine, I cooked a bunch. I've always liked to cook. But I think during the quarantine, it really became like more of a necessity because everything was closed. So I really would get really inventive with my creative dishes. And through Chef's Table, I kind of was trying to try different things. So that was a lot of fun. And I love to play soccer. I'm a huge soccer guy. I've always been. But because of the quarantine, obviously, I couldn't play with people. So I would get with the close circle that I was with, and we would just kind of play around a bunch just to stay active because I needed to be outside as much as I could.
Yeah, that sounds fun.
Yeah, and then during the quarantine, I had a bunch of my people that I've worked with in the past just ask them, hey, what movies do I need to watch? Like, what are your favorite? And I have this whole huge list on my notes app of all the movies that I've seen during the quarantine. I can't think of them now, but I've seen so many movies. I think every day I was watching 2 movies.
Oh, that's fun. That's such a good time to kind of catch up to, like when the world slows down.
Yeah, you can
hone in on my craft.
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, getting straight into all of the Blue Miracle, like goodness, describe your character in like your own words. What do you think, I guess, are his like best and worst qualities?
So I think Moco is an incredibly dynamic character, obviously very complicated too, because I think he struggles a lot with rejection, and I think he does struggle a lot with denial. And denial is a super interesting thing because it just comes from a place of hurt and it comes from a place of pain, and obviously rejection does too. So I think Moco, not having grown up around his father and kind of not knowing where his mother is, he builds a lot of character to stand up for himself and to live life on his own. And within those things, I think that he is able to find love through the character and through the hardship that he's been through, right? He definitely feels like he can't relate to any of the other kids. He's much older, not that much, but the age difference to him is a big deal. But once he starts to learn their struggles and really understand what they've been through, I think that he starts to connect with them. And I think that's one of his best traits. He's a very smart kid. although he does get himself into trouble. But that smartness and that attuneness to what's going on around him, I think is his one of his best qualities.
Yeah, definitely. Like you mentioned, it was clear throughout the movie that he had to kind of build this wall.
Yeah, totally.
And I think one of the most refreshing parts was to see it slowly, you know, like crumble. You don't need it.
And they didn't give up on him.
Yeah.
So I think that was his first taste of like, wow, this person never gave up on me.
Such a sweet story. Yeah. I was looking into everything a little bit more, you know, kind of after watching the movie and to prepare for this interview, and it's based on a true story. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right. That's totally right.
What did you do to kind of prepare for that? Like, did you research?
When I read the script, and one of the first things that it said was it was based on a true story. So I read through the script and was like, there's no way I've never heard of this story. Like, how do we not know about this? At least me personally, that's how I felt. So I immediately researched, I watched a bunch of YouTube clips, and looked at the orphanage and what they had been through and the timeline of everything. And I was just amazed with the storyline. And the more research I did on the orphanage and the kids in the orphanage, the more it spoke to the character and spoke to the whole story in general. And that was kind of my preparation with getting to know Moco, doing my research of these people in the orphanage, and just watching a lot of YouTube and getting really, I also looked at a bunch of news articles that were coming out about the story and looking at pictures. I really like to work when I'm acting, I work with iconic images. So I kind of base my characters off of real photography. And that really helps me a lot when I'm working on a character.
Wow, that's such a cool process. I've never really heard of turning to images, like still images rather than like inspirational, you know, actors and characters.
Yeah, one of my professors, she's amazing. Her name is Stephanie Schroyer. She kind of taught me that, and it's in my toolbox, but it's a great place for me to start, you know, looking at real people and being able to make costume and physicality choices and energy choices based off of those real people. So it's really great.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah. So you spoke about, you know, that experience of like getting the script for the first time and seeing that it was based on a true story. What was your entire audition process like, especially with this being one of your first major, I saw you did a few other roles in the past, but with this being, you know, Netflix. And...
Yeah, no, of course. Long story short, I saw this breakdown, and at the time I didn't have representation, and I saw the role and I read the script and was like, I can do this role. I know that I can really fight for it. So I sent out many personal emails. I had been to a film festival and I found out that the guy at the film festival knew Julio, the director, and got in touch with them. And through a long series of emails, they actually let me send in a tape. And after the tape, I got called in to the Carla Hull casting office, and they're amazing people there. And Natalie Ballesteros was one of the people who at casting who really believed in me and really helped me throughout that process. And then I got a call back, and then I met the producers. And that was pretty much it. But it was a long, long process in the beginning of me being really active about, hey, I'm gonna push for this. I see this role. I see that I wanna tell this story. You know, and I sent out many, many emails. So I eventually got the audition through that.
Yeah, no, that's so beautiful. Because as you're talking, all I could think about was, you know, just a few minutes ago, we talked about how in order for your character in the film to break down these walls, he formed relationships and then like relied on those relationships. Yeah. So then to hear that, you know, to get this role, you looked back at your relationships and you kind of made those connections that it seems like.
You're so right.
Yeah, it was like meant to be, right?
Yeah, it really does feel meant to be.
Real quick, what do you think is like the strongest message that you would like fans of the movie and just new watchers to kind of take away?
Sure. I think what I really hope they learn is that, you know, through perseverance, hard work, and, you know, a little bit of faith, you can get through anything and you can really achieve your goals. I really feel like that's the message of this beautiful story. You know, and even for kids, even for adults, I think that if you work hard towards something and you really fight for it, then you can achieve your dreams and get to where you need to be.
Yeah. I think,
yeah.
Yeah, that's beautiful. I love that. We have a few minutes left. What do you want? Like, what's next for you? I read in your bio you're interested in like directing a little bit, as well as you have another project, I think, coming up with ABC, right?
Yes, that's right. I'm currently in Atlanta. That's why you see my hotel room here. I'm currently in Atlanta and I'm filming a ABC pilot called Promised Land, which is an all Latin drama about a family vying for wealth in Sonoma County, and a bunch of power dynamics that go on within the very, very wealthy family that are up there in the north of California. And I play Junior, who is the youngest of the siblings. And I'm quite the character. And yeah, I'm
a younger sibling in real life. Like, are you able to kind of take that into your role?
I have an older sister.
Okay.
But this kid is definitely one of a kind. It's very interesting, this character, because he has so much wealth. And I think that, you know, with a lot of wealth comes a lot of power. And sometimes we don't necessarily use that in the right way. So it's kind of a dive deep into affluency and that kind of struggle within a kid.
Yeah, that sounds interesting. Yeah. Wow, very new. Like, that doesn't sound like anything I've seen on TV right now. Well, this was great. Thank you so much for taking the time to chat with us. I am so excited to see everyone's reaction to this film when it comes out.
Me too.
It'll be fun. Thank you. Have a good rest of your day.
You too.